What Yeah, I'm going. No, it's like, what's your point? Come on. Good afternoon here from Flint, Michigan. Steve Schmidt Gymnasium Ballinger Fieldhouse, home of the Mop Bears for the Great Lakes Tournament District A Championship here this afternoon. It's our 1:30 matchup, a couple minutes late. Just finished up a trophy ceremony for the Jackson College, the Jets. They were able to get it done in their championship. They advanced and they're heading off to the national championship. Got an exciting matchup here today. It's our District A championship game. We've got the Mid-Michigan College, the Lakers. They will be the home team. They will show up as Mott on the scoreboard. They're the home team coming in at 28-1. The visitors are the Hawks. They will be the guests on the board. Hawks are coming in at 13-5 overall. Both teams got it done on Thursday. Lakers were able to beat the Ocelots from Schoolcraft 76-72, and the Hawks were able to get by the Cougars 85-75. So here we are, the 1:30 championship game. All right, so we got some lineups to get through here for both teams. All right, I'm going to go in order on the sheet, not necessarily the numerical order on our roster. So a 5'7" sophomore guard from Hillard, Ohio, played at Hillard Derby. Number 10, Tayen Brown. A 5'8" freshman guard from Newark, Ohio, number 32, Brielle Gingras. A 5'7" freshman guard from Nelsonville, Ohio, played at Nelsonville, York, number 2, Kaylee Dupler. A 5'8" freshman guard from Logan, Ohio, Burn Union, number 22, Emily Blevins. And a 5'9" freshman forward from Middletown, Ohio, number 21, Trinity Beller. The Hawks are coached by head coach Seth Martin. Assistant coaches Trevor Blevins and Mandy Martin. All right, that's our lineup for the Hawks. As mentioned, the Lakers coming in at 28-1 overall, 13-1 in conference, first in the Northern Conference. They've got a 9-game win streak. But none of that matters now. They're in the championship game. If you're the Hocking Hawks, you have a few less wins, but it just comes down to this. Got to play 40 minutes of basketball to see what happens. Mid-Michigan Lakers, probably the heavy favorite, I would imagine. But we'll go through some of their yearly annual stats in conference, I guess, overall conference lead in some of these categories. But here's a starter. 5'8", freshman guard from Everett, Michigan, played at Everson High School, number 2, Addison Gray. A 5'6", sophomore guard from LC, Michigan, played at Ovid LC High School, number 11, Kaylin Walter. A 5'9", freshman guard, slash forward from Hemlock High School, number 14, Chloe Watson. A 5'10", sophomore forward from Saginaw's Heritage High School, number 20, Terea Moore. And a 5'6", freshman from Saginaw, played at Swan Valley High School, number 22, Rachel Rezio. The Lakers, coached by head coach Lance Meany. And on the bench, assistants Tanner Smith, Austin Mayfield, Jewel Larkin, and Christian Boer. Rezio leads the point average, the highest point average for the Lakers with 15.2. Watson with 14.1, Moore with 11 points. For the Hawks, Gingras averaging 16.5, Brown with 13.2, and just about 10 for Dupler. Hawks averaging 65 points a game, 85 points on the season for the Lakers. They're only giving up 50.6, so they can get it done on the offensive end, shut down on the defensive end. That's about a 35-point margin. That's first overall in conference. On top of that, they lead in rebound margin overall, steals per game, assists per game, and they're opposing opponent's field goal percentage. And then the other big thing that they lead is a home attendance up there in the North Country here in Michigan. So I'm assuming we got a lot of eyeballs on this one. We're on our YouTube, our Mott Bears YouTube account. So we appreciate you tuning in. All right, just underway, no score, 9-18. Hocking with a shot high off the glass, the rebound. The putback is no good. That's boarded by the Lakers. I think that was Bellard shot off the mark. Try to get it inside to Moore and look for Walter on the cut. That goes out of bounds. So it's Hawks basketball. And speaking of Hawks, we'll be seeing some Hawks tomorrow afternoon. The Hawks men's team are also in the championship game. Coach Ryan Miley and the team, you could probably see them on the left of your screen back there behind the Hocking bench. Should be a good game. We got Hawks in the North tomorrow. But it's Hawks and Lakers here today. Moore with it. Bellard with the reach and foul. That stops the clock with 8:43 left. Bellard with her first team foul for the Hawks. Walter tried to get it inside to Moore. Lost the handle. but able to keep it alive. It's up top down to Rizzio. Three-pointer on the way for Walter from the wing, in and out. Moore tipped it out, picked up there by Rizzio. And if you're on the channel, you're watching, I think we got 111 on there. Welcome to put a comment. Try to respond to everything I can. And I'll put in my Twitter / X in there as well. Anybody you want to tweet at me, X at me, whatever it's called, you're welcome to do so. I'll do my best to respond. A lot of good chatter in these games. It's been fun to interact with the fans. And especially if I butcher any of these names. I take great pride in getting notes from the coaches, but during the pregame, the music is so loud, sometimes it's hard to hear. So I want to make sure I get it right for grandma and grandpa and aunts and uncles and parents back home. Rebound off the glass, picked up by Moore. The putback is no good. Loose ball. Hawks have it. Nice job there by Gingrich. I think Moore had a handle on it, and a hand to keep it alive as well. Brown works off the screen, inside. Nice pass there to Bellard, but that shot was off the mark. Ball goes out of bounds. Looks like it was knocked away by the Lakers. Cordy Smith checks in, a 6'1" sophomore forward from Champaign, Illinois. So I can pull up some of the games from Thursday. So I'd mentioned Mid-Michigan, they were in a nail-biter there. They won 76-72 over Schoolcraft. Led by Chloe Watson with 31 points in that one. Rezio with 19. And the Hawks were able to put away the Cougars 85-75. Gingrich had 30, and Brown with 21. Three-pointer on the way. That's in and out. That was Brown with the miss. Rebound, Rezio. Outlet to Watson. Over to Walter in the corner for three, and in and out. Loose ball picked up by Huker. Huker now on the floor, the 5'11" freshman from McBain. We appreciate the opportunity to not only bring you these games today on the broadcast, but to host this tournament. It's our third year straight, this Great Lakes tournament. Our Bears Nation here likes to roll out the red carpet, make sure everybody's having a good time, and this team has just worked tirelessly around the clock to make this experience as enjoyable as possible. Everybody behind the scenes, everybody at the table, the staff. Three-pointer on the way. That's Gingrich off the mark, off the side of the rim. Goes out of bounds. It's Laker basketball. 6:51 left here in the first. A lot of action, but no points yet. Both teams settling in for this championship match, this District A championship game. That's Paige Ebels. Gave up the shot, got it inside to Huker for two. A nice take there by Blevins. Down the lane, she goes, couldn't get the shot away, but she was fouled. She hit the deck. Terea Moore gets called for that foul. That's her first, the team's first. Trinity Bellard checks back in for the Hawks. And we've got a substitution. I want to say unfortunately there's a substitution for the Lakers. I missed it. Hard to keep an eye on things. A lot of moving parts in these games. It might have been Gray checking back in. Addison Gray. So Gray, Watson, Huker, Moore, Rezio. Nope, Moore's out. So foul call on the play. That's a second now on Bellard. And Hawks come away with it. Gingrich has it. Off the window, no. Loose ball. Picked up in the corner by number two, Kaylee Dupler. Down low. Oh, Smith had it, lost the handle, but tough to Dupler now. And Dupa coughed it up. Lakers basketball. Rezio, pick that one up. Gray gets it out to Ebel. And rebound with Cordy Smith. Still 2-0. 5.5 left. Payne Brown with a long jumper. Probably about 18 points or 18 footer. That goes down. 2-2. Oh, good. Thank you, Jennifer Brown. It's Hooker. All right. I will change that for sure. Appreciate that. That's one that's honestly, it didn't come up. We went over Ebel, Torreya Moore. So I will, in fact, send Dante at the scores table across the gym here and let him know. Blevins with that basket. 4-2 lead now for the Hawks. Inside. And Smith had the rebound, but kind of left it out there. And Rezio did a good job of tying her up. So possession arrow stays with the Lakers. All right, we've got Torreya Moore checking back in. Looks like Caitlin Walter on the floor. And Leah Helsel checks in, the 5'8 freshman from Manton High School. Three more of the shot, pump fake. She goes up. And she's fouled. That shot was off the mark, but she'll be headline to shoot two.
Her first and third,
Torreya Moore. Torreya Moore averaging 65% from the stripe. That foul was on number 23, Dasani Morrow, the 5'8 sophomore guard from Cincinnati. Came to Hocking from Withrow University. That's her first. Third team foul now for the Hawks. Moore missed the second, actually missed the bolt. 4-2 lead for in favor of the Hawks. They have it down low. Brown tracks it down, gets it over to Gingras. Gingras, oh. That was Dupler, her first basket. 4 minutes to play, 7-2 now. Hawks, Helsel. Walter in the corner, and that's off the front of the rim. Walter gets her own rebound. Kaylin Walter following her shot. The putback, big basket there to slow down that Hawks momentum. Walter with her first basket at 7-4 with 3:48 left. We got a timeout. It's like a 30-second timeout. Hawks lead by 3, 7-4 over the Lakers. Yeah, I do appreciate the help. We've been split between play-by-play and color. Tom Cavanaugh, he's been here, but we've been kind of splitting the games, and we did a few games together. Unfortunately, he's not here today, so flying solo. So, Jennifer Brown, thank you for helping out there. All right, Hawks with it. Up the left side, up top to Brown. Back up top to Gingras. 3:35 left. 7-4 lead for the Hawks. Hawks out of the OCCAC conference. And part of the NJCAA Region 12. Three-pointer on the way for the Lakers. That was Rezio. That was short. Picked up by Morrow. Oh, Down to 10 on the shot clock. Inside to Blevins. Outside to Dupler. It goes. In, out, and back in. Two-point basket for Dupler. 5 points for Kaylee Dupler from Nelsonville, Ohio. Drive, Rezio, hard off the glass. Offensive board, the putback is good for Chloe Watson. They cut it to 9-6. Hawks. Hawks get it across midcourt. Brown dribbling through traffic. Pulls up for the jumper, and she's going to be fouled by Moore. That's second on Moore now. All right, checking in, we've got number 34, Kaylee Hooker, back on the floor for the Lakers. I think it was Gray checking back in for the Hawks, number 12, Courtney Smith. So Brown at the line shooting two. Brown averaging 65% from the stripe. Made the first. Made them both. Brown averaging 13 on the season. She's already got 4 points. 2:07 left here in the first. I definitely remember calling Caitlin Walter over to Elsie. They came out to Goodrich, I think it was last year. They got a good basketball team up there in Ovid. I do the basketball games for the Martians, so you may recognize my voice if you tuned in there on NFHS Network. Three-pointer on the way for Brown. That doesn't go. Blevins with the putback is good. Emily Blevins with the offensive board, cleaning the glass. She's now got 4 points. And it's a 13-6 lead for the Hawks. In the corner is Helsel. That's too strong. And that's Blevins with that rebound. Outlet to Gingras up the left side, right in front of the Lakers bench. Under a minute to play here in the first. Dupler up and under and no good. Hooker with that board. Nice job there by the Lakers to knock that loose. I just think she kind of lost the handle. Helsel over to Gray. Outside to Rezio for three. Short. Rezio with the offensive. She had position. I think she got tangled up with Brown. Looks like she's pretty close to getting that board. Tay and Brown gets called for that one. Geriatru CC checks in. Harrison High School product, the 6-foot freshman. Inside, the Hooker up off the window, and no. Put back is good. CeCe comes in off the bench. Immediate basket. And it's 13-8. That's a big basket for the Lakers as the first quarter comes down to an and a turnover. That's a double dribble call. So the Lakers got 11.2 to work with here in the first quarter. The 13.8 lead. Hooker's got 3 seconds, not blocked. Out to Watson. Wow, what a play there by. That was Gingras with the block and got the shot off. I want about 2 seconds. So at the end of the first quarter, it is the Hawks 13 and the Lakers 8. We'll take a break here. Dupler leading the way for the Hawks with 5 after one quarter of play. All right, we'll be right back. Thanks, everybody, for tuning in. All right, coming out of the break, second quarter getting started. Hawks on top 13-8. Hawks basketball. Gingras with it. Leaves it for Brown. Watson all over her. Brown drives. Lost the handle. Picked up by the Lakers. Hooker looks for the outlet. Back to Watson. Hooker had it knocked away by the Hawks. Good defense there. I think Dupler got a hand on that. Lakers had an opportunity to get out and run. Just couldn't get it out in anybody in front of Hooker. I think Watson tried to catch up, but it's just too late. Gingras for three. That's too strong. Rebound Hooker. Hooker on the block. Leaves it for Cece, but she lost the handle, but made its way to Watson. Trying to get it back into Hooker, but knocked out of bounds. I think that was Cordy Smith got a hand on it. Rezio checks back in along with Moore. Two leading scorers on the season for the Lakers, 15 and 14, but they trial by five. The Moore shot all rolls off the rim. Rebound in traffic there, Courtney Smith. And Lakers, they're averaging, let's see what they're averaging about 20% from the stripe. Hawks with another basket. That was Dupler. She's now got seven. Lead is 7 points. Rezio, pump fake. To Watson, drives, gets in the lane. The floater does not go. Rebound, Dupler. Quick outlet to Gingras. Off and running. Here come the Hawks the other way. Gingras kicked it back out. Dupler for three. That's off the mark. Goes out of bounds. So 15-8, 8:17 left. Substitution, Caitlin Walter checks back in. And number 23, Dasane Morrow for the Hawks. Oh, Watson had to go out of bounds. Brown with it down the lane. Some contact down low, and they're going to call the offensive foul. Great job there by Moore to step in and draw that charge. Second foul now on Brown. And shout out to Tom Cavanaugh helping me out with these pronunciations as well. Sounds like I misinterpreted another one. It's Sissy, not Cece. So thank you, big Tom Cavanaugh. We'll see him tomorrow here. His voice will be nicely rested up. We'll probably give him the play-by-play all day. All right, rebound. Ripped out there by Blevins. Outlet to Morrow. And knocked loose there by Watson, but Blevins able to, or Morrow able to keep it, but she lost it. Here's Rezio down the lane, and she fouls. Gingras going to get called for that one. Rezio heading the line, shooting two. Rezio is averaging 89% from the stripe. Gray checks back in. Sissy checks back in. Sissy. Sissy, all right, I got it right. Okay, so Rezio out the line shooting two. And missed the first. Made the second, 15-9, 7:24 left. Over to Morrow in the corner for three, and it's down. Dasane Morrow knocking it down. It's a 9-point lead now for the Hawks. As I mentioned at the beginning, throw out these records. Got to get it done here. And That was Gingras with the steal. The lefty scoop rolls off the rim. She's fouled. Heading the line shooting two. Terea Moore checks back in. We've got Trinity Bellard back on the floor. Gingras averaging 65%. Here to shoot two. First one off the back of the rim. Big rebound there by Moore. Off the second miss by Gingras. Lakers trail by nine. 6:50 left here in the first half. They're going to claw their way back into this one. That three's off the mark. Rezio, her shot doesn't fall. That board cleared by Emily Blevins. Hand off to Morrow. And Gingras able to track that down, and she's fouled. Paige Ebels going to get called for that one. That's her first. Second team foul here in the quarter. Kaylee Hooker checks back in. Hawks ball on the inbound in front of the Lakers bench. Blevins has it, drives, trying to find Bellard. That shot rolls off the rim. The offensive board, the putback is good. Bellard now with two, and the lead is 11. Inside Hooker, back outside to Rezio. 16-footer goes. Foul line extended. 22-11, 6:09 left. Three-pointer on the way. That's Morrow in the corner. Shots off the mark. Big rebound there by Moore. Moore getting it done on the glass on the defensive end. Three-pointer for Gray is off the mark. But Hooker in the paint. Oh, we got a jump ball. Wow, Hooker with the putback. The basket was good, but it was waved off. And jump ball, possession arrow goes to Hocking, so no basket. So still a nine-point lead for the Hawks.
Correction, possession arrow is in Michigan.
Okay, so they change it up. So the possession arrow is going to go over to the Lakers. They get the inbound underneath their basket. Discussion over at the table. So we got Moore, Hooker, Rezio, Gray, and Watson on the inbound for the Lakers. And that basket goes. I think that was Gray. It is. So you got Gingras, Blevins, Dupler, Bellard. That shot's off the mark. And number 12, Courtney Smith on the floor. And it looks like we got a blocking call. Oh, no, that was a jump ball. Excuse me. So now that's Hawks basketball. Geriatru Sissy on the floor now for the Lakers. Gingras has it. Lost the handle, but picked up by Blevins. Through the lane. Shot goes off the back of the rim. Rebound. Lakers. Hooker with that board. Outlet to Watson. There's Gray in the corner for three. And it's off. Just off the rim. But rebound tracked down by Rezio. Over to Watson from the wing. That shot's off the mark. And Lakers stay with it. Rezio, jumper, off the glass, no. But Hooker with a putback, off the rim. Rebound, Courtney Smith. Lakers had an opportunity there to cut into that lead. Couldn't get it done. Dupler, the floater. And that doesn't go, but they're going to call Courtney Smith on the over-the-back call. Now, the interesting thing here for the Hawks, there's only seven total players, so they're not real deep. It'll be interesting to see if these fouls start to pile up for the Hawks. All right, a substitution for the Lakers. I think it was Kalen Walter that checked back in. So 4:37. It's a 7-point lead. Hawks on top, 20-13. Hooker inside, outside to Rezio. Dribbles, drives, kicks it out to Walter for three. Off the side of the rim. A nice four there by Chloe Watson, but knocked loose by, that was Trinity Beller, got a hand on that, knocked it loose. And there is a whistle. Now, there's a foul call. That might be on Terea Moore, gets called. And that is going to be her third foul for the Lakers. That's a big foul with 4:20 left, so she's heading out. Leah Helsel checks back in. Moore averaging 11 points on the season, so she heads to the bench. Nice play there by the Hawks to get it in. Tic-tac-toe inside to Courtney Smith for two and leads back to nine. 22-13, 4 minutes to go here in the first half. Also for three and off the mark. Rebound, Trinity Belliard. Out of bounds. And that is going to be Lakers basketball. Paige Ebels back on the floor, checks in for Helsel. So Lakers have an opportunity to cut in this lead with 3:48. It's a 9-point deficit right now. Need some good possession, says Coach Lance Maney. And nice block there out of bounds. Courtney Smith stops the clock with 3:37, 19 on the shot clock. And wow, Gingras with a steal. Down the lane, lefty scoop, too strong. But waiting there is number 21, Trinity Bellers, the putback. It's good. Hawks up by 11, 3:25 left. Three-pointer on the way. Ebels kicks it out to Walter for three. Off the side of the rim. Another rebound for Bellard. The Lakers are shooting 17%. Smith's shot rolls off the rim. They haven't, not only the shooting 17% from the floor, they are 0-17 from three-point land. And they trail by 11. Plenty of time left here in this ball game if you're a Lakers fan. 2:50 left here in the first half. But the score is 24-13. Hawks getting it done. They're averaging. They're 30%. They're 2-10 from downtown. They are out rebounding the Lakers by one. 8 offensive rebounds for the Hawks. 12 on the offensive glass for the Lakers. Dupla leading the way with 7 for the Hawks. Brown, Bellard, Levens each with 4. Rezio, leading scorer for the Lakers with 3. 4-5 players now at 2. So 2:50 left, 24-13. It is Lakers basketball. For this Women's Great Lake District A Championship game. Hooker to Rezio to Walter. That shot's off the mark. And Kaylee Hooker with the offensive board. She fouled on the putback. She'll be headlined to shoot two. So second foul now on Smith. That's her second. Fourth team foul on the Hawks. Hooker got it to go. It's Second one off the mark. Grezio kept it alive, but no, she stepped out of bounds. Good effort there by Rachel Grezio from Swan Valley High School. But she stepped on the line. So it is the Hawks basketball. They're up by 10, 24-14. Substitution on the floor. It's Chiriantu Sissy. Just checks in from Harrison. .220 left. 14 on the shot clock. Down to 10. Dupler has it. Gets in the lane. Hook shot, no. That goes out of bounds. Kept alive there by Hooker. Picked up by the Hawks. But the Lakers able to come away with it. Watson off and running up the right side. Walter drives, kicks it out to Rezio. Under 2 minutes to play. Watson for three, and that's a good. Finally, a three-pointer that goes down if you're a Laker fan. I think that's the first one in 18 attempts. And a foul call on the Hawks. I believe that's going to be maybe not a foul call. That might have been stepped out of bounds. So that's Lakers basketball. They now trail by 7. Rezio with it. Ebel has it. Lost the handle. Picked it up. Inside to Sissy. That's knocked loose by Blevins. Down the lane she goes. And a lot of contact there. Both players hit the deck. Sissy and Blevins. And that foul is going to be on Blevins. So 14 foul. Second on Blevins. 1:26 left here in the first. 24-17. Addison Gray checks in. Three-pointer on the way. That's Morrow. That's off the back of the rim. Rebound tracked down there by Courtney Smith. Kept alive by the Hawks. That's Emily Blevins. Drives the lane, the baseline, got it up and in. Back to a 9-point lead. Rezio, and she's fouled. She'll be heading to the line. They're saying two shots. That is a Hawks now with their fifth, so the Lakers are in the bonus. That puts Rezio at the line shooting two. I'm pretty sure she was lights out when it came to her percentage. Yep, 89%. And looks like Ebel checks back in. Walter goes out. 1:04 left on the clock. Lakers trail by 9. Two free throws coming up here, courtesy of Rezio. And rattles and falls. He's now 8 points. Made them both. Two big free throws there. Cuts the lead to 7. 1 minute to play here in the first half of this District 8 championship game. Hawks getting it done. Lakers trying to claw their way back in. The heavy favorite. Credit to the Hawks for coming out and just battling. The Lakers are a tough team. You know they're going to have some fight left in here down the stretch. This one will probably go down to the wire. It'll be a lot of fun. So the lead is still 7 points. Knocked loose there by the Lakers out of bounds. That stops the clock with 42. 8 seconds on the shot clock. Kalen Walter checks in. Blevins has it. 5 on the shot clock. Gingras, step back, shot. Off the back of the rim, rebound. That was great, a travel call. She got that horn kind of caused her to pause for a moment. So that's a fresh 30. 32 on the game clock. Blevins up top to Dupler. Dupler all the way out to midcourt. Walter out on her. 16 on the game clock. Kupler double team. Turnover, Lakers. Ebles drops it for Watson, up and in. Lefty lays it up off the glass. 5-point lead now for the Lakers. And the buzzer, that shot isn't going to count. Blevins got it off, but not in time. And so one half is complete. It's the Hawks from Hocking College. They lead 26-21 over the Mid-Michigan College Lakers. We will take a break here, and we'll come back here with some stats. Thanks, everybody, for tuning in. Hope you're having fun. Coming out of the second half here, the Hawks lead by 5, 26-21. Lakers with it to start the second half. Inside to Hooker, up and in. Just how they drew it up in halftime. Three-point game, 26-23 now in favor of the Hawks. And travel call on the Hawks. That's a turnover. It's Lakers basketball. Lakers shot 21% in the first half. They averaged 45% from the floor, 85 points a game, and they put up 21. But looking to rebound here in the second. Hooker on the glass. That doesn't go. Rebound, Gingrich. Down the left side, off the window, no. Rebound, Gingrich still has it. Able to get loose. Got the shot off. No call. Gingrich hit the deck. Hooker clears. Outlet to Watson. They're looking to run. In the corner for Gray, and that's through. We are all tied up. 26-26. 5-0 run. To start the third. Minute five gone. It's all Lakers here. Gingrich for three. The step back is down. Big basket there by Trail Gingrich, the make. That was Gingrich's first points, I believe, if I'm not mistaken. Surprising. Gingrich averaging 16 and a half. He had her team led at the half by 5. And the Hawks had it knocked away. Lakers pick it up. Here comes Watson. Watson to Rezio in the corner, three-pointer, and that's down. Rachel Rezio knocks it in, and it's a three, or a tie, it's all tied up, 3-3. Excuse me, 29-29, back-to-back threes. Another three on the way for, that was Dupler. Rebound, scooped up by Walter. Outlet to Rezio. Walter thought about the three. Rezio buried it. Now it's a three-point lead for the Lakers. Lakers coming to life here in the second half. Brown drives. Tried to get the shot off. She was fouled. Should be heading line to shoot two.
Personal foul, 34.
11-3. Score in favor of the Lakers here in the third. Tane Brown at the line shooting two. Brown's averaging 65%. Brown made the second. Leaps to 32-30. Terea Moore checks in. Watson, or Hooker goes out, excuse me. Three-pointer on the way for Watson. Off the front of the rim. Loose ball picked up by Galen Walter. Back up top to Rezio. Watson to Gray for three. Off the back of the rim. Loose ball. That's rebounded by the Hawks. That was Blevins. They got a hand on that. Brown. Down the lane she goes. Got the shot off, but they call a travel call. Substitutions for the Hawks. It's Kaylee Dupler checks in. And for the Lakers, number 10, Paige Ebels. Inside to Moore on from the elbow. Back up top, or outside to Ebels. Rezio drives, hands off to Gray. Ebels in the lane, lost the handle, kicked it out to Rezio for three. That's off the side of the rim. A rebound. Paige Ebels able to keep it alive for the Lakers. Watson for three from the corner, and that's down. Chloe Watson knocked it down. Great job there by Ebels to keep that alive. Good ball movement there for the Lakers, and they lead by five. 5:59 left in the third. It's a 14-4 run for the Lakers to start this one, and that rebound scooped up by Watson. Correa Moore heads on the block. Kicked it out to Rezio. Good ball movement here by the Lakers. Looking for an open shot. And there's a foul call on the Hawks. That's a blocking call. That's going to be on Dupler, her second. And first team foul here for the Hawks in the second half, in the third quarter specifically. So Lakers on the inbound. They now lead by five. Trailed by five at halftime. Plus 10 here in the third. And loose ball. That goes out of bounds off the Lakers. That's Hawks basketball. Haley Hooker checks back in. Gingrich drives, knocked loose there by the Lakers. Picked up by Blevins. Inside to number 12, Courtney Smith. Nice job there by Smith to get it done around the rim. Three-point lead now for the Lakers. Watson, the pump fake, tries, kicked it out to Gray in the corner for three. Addison Gray knocked it down. 8 points now for Gray. The lead back up to six. I think this is the largest lead for the Lakers. They trailed by five at half. Three-pointer on the way for Dupler. And that goes out of bounds. 4:33 left. Kaylen Walter checks back in. Ebels goes out. Good crowd here from Mid-Michigan. Filled the gym here. We've got a few from Hocking. I think probably most of their folks are tuning in online. It looks like obviously the basketball team over there. Inside to Smith. Back up top to Gingrich. And nice shot there from the free throw line. That's Emily Blevins for two. 8 points now for Blevins. The lead is 4 points. So 3:57 left here in the third quarter. It's the Lakers on top. 38-34 over the Hawks. We'll be right back.
should I really even start? I got $2 million.
Coming out of the break, 3:57 left here in the third. It's Lakers basketball on the inbound. Watson has it inside to Hooker. Hooker hands off to, that's Kalen Walter with it. That shot's off the mark. Rebound, that was Blevin. Rip that one down for the Hawks. Here they come the other way. They're down by four, 3:35 left. Brown. Dupler back to Brown. Goes baseline. Up and in. Nice take there. Tan Brown with the basket. Seven now for Brown. The lead is two. Rezio had it in traffic. In the lane. Hammered from behind. Rezio heading to the line to shoot two. That foul was on. Looks like that was on Gingrich. Gingrich's second team foul for the Hawks. Paige Evils checks in. So you got Moore, Rezio, Evils, Walter, Watson. For the Hawks, you've got Smith, Gingrich, Dupler, Blevins, and Brown. First one is good for Rezio. Made them both. Two big free throws there. Push the lead to four. 3:10 left. Brown drops it for Blevins. Up the middle of the court. Got Gingrich waiting in the wing for the three-pointer, but Brown tried to get the shot off. Kind of lost the handle, picked up by the Lakers. Walter with the scoop. That doesn't go. Moore crashed in for that rebound, but it goes out of bounds. That three-pointer for Brown's off the mark. Ebels scooped up that one. Four-point lead. Lakers, 2:33 left in the third. Paige Ebel, the floater. It goes from inside the paint. 42-36, 2:17 left. Back to a six-point lead now for the Lakers. Smith with the turnaround. That rolls off the rim, but we got a foul call. I think that's going to be on Smith. After the play, that's her third foul. We'll keep an eye on those fouls for both teams. But as mentioned, the Lakers, or the Hawks, excuse me, have a bit of a short bench. Yeah, it looks like three now on Smith, two for Dupler, Brown, Ballard, and Gingrich. Three for Terea Moore and two for Rezio for the Lakers. 1:50 left. Backdoor cut there, Rezio. Tried to find her, but Gingrich stepped in front of that. Down the lane, lefty, scoop and score. Nice move there by Gingrich to get to the basket. Cut that lead to four. Gingrich now with 5 points. 1:35 left. Here in this District A championship game. And Rezio, that shot's too strong. That rebound picked up by Blevins. Here come the Hawks the other way. Up to Brown. Brown pulls up for the jumper. That's off the front of the rim. A little short. Caitlin Walter with that rebound. And it's up to Watson. And Moore got it down low. She was fouled. She'll be heading to the line shooting two. Blevins gets called for that, her first. Fourth team foul here in the third. Looks like we've got Addison Gray checking back in. Kaylee Hooker looking to come back in as well. Assuming she's going in for Moore, who's at the line right now. Lakers looking to add to their four-point lead. 102 left here in the third. Out. Hooker checks back in. It's a five-point lead now for the Lakers. Looking to put this one away here down the stretch. Improved to 29-1, but the Hawks have stood mightily today. They led at halftime. And looking to stay in it. Gingras for three. It's good. Great shot there by Gingras. 7 points now. That cuts the lead to two. These Hawks just won't go away. Rezio hands off to Walter. Walter for three, and that's down. Kaylin Walter answers for the Lakers, pushes the lead back to five. Big basket there. 20 seconds left here in the third. Tayan Brown has it up top. Down to about 12 to go. Cross-court pass to Dupler for three. That's off the front of the rim, but Blevins has it. She was fouled. She hits the deck. That's going to be a Lakers foul. That is their second foul. So that stops the clock with 4.8. They had fouls to give. Four, in fact. So the Hawks have about 4 seconds to do something with it, and they do. Grill Gingras able to knock that down, cuts the lead back to three. So the Lakers came out swinging after halftime, overtook the lead, built a 6-point lead over the Hawks, but they fought back to cut that lead to three with 10 minutes to go here in the District A Great Lakes Women's Tournament Championship. All right, some of our sponsors. Attorney Matt Norwood supports local athletes and is here for all your legal needs. A lot of action, a lot of moving parts in the collegiate athletic atmosphere right now, so Matt Norwood is your guy. Give him a shout. Johnson and Wood, Mechanical Construction Company, HVAC Plumbing here in Flint Town. Luigi, for over 65 years, Luigi's has been making the area's best thin crust pizza. You can stop by after the game. They have great Italian American classics, and there's a 10% off coupon in the program. Luigi's, a proud sponsor and supporter of Mont Athletics. And Ben Johnson Law, don't go one-on-one when you're fighting for justice. Ben Johnson, we go hard in the paint to score the justice you deserve. Visit VenFights.com or call 855-VEN-FIGHTS today. Fox's Pub and Grill is the best pizza in town. Daily from 11:30 to 2 a.m. right off of Linden Road. They're open daily. Klein, Klein, and Griffin provides premier legal expertise and service since 1928. All right, back underway here in the fourth. Gingras has it. Watson kind of pester her, but Gingras stays with it. Cross-court pass out of bounds. That's a turnover, Lakers basketball. So through three quarters, Lakers now shooting 29%, 33% for the Hawks. Moore has it, hands off to Rezio. Baseline, her shot, her path is blocked. And Hawks basketball, good defense there by the Hawks to force that turnover. Levin's on the inbound. 9:33 left. Brown. Kingston drives down the lane. She gets called for double dribble. Watson to Moore. Moore has it. Hands off to Rezio. Rezio down the lane. She goes. Shot is good, but there's no basket. She was fouled. That foul was on number 21, Bellard. That's her third. Rezio leading the way for the Lakers now with 13. Watson has 10. Watson in the corner for three. That shot's off the back of the rim and a rebound. That was Trinity Bellard. Pulls that one down for the Hawks. Here comes Blevins the other way. Hands off to Brown and a travel call. Turnover, Lakers basketball. With 8:57 left, they lead by three, 46-43.
Lakers ball,
number 12, Courtney Smith back on the floor now for the Hawks. Gray drives baseline. Up in, oh, looks good, but off the mark. Lakers pull down their offensive board. Moore able to secure that. Moore on the pass from Watson. No. Gingras clears it for the Hawks. Up the middle of the court. Bellard lost the handle, picked up by Moore. Lakers basketball. They lead by three, 8:19 left. Terea Moore up and under, foul call. That's going to be on Courtney Smith. Moore going to head the line, shooting two with 8:06 left. Moore averaging 65%. It's like Tayan Brown checks in. Trinity Bellard checks out for the Hawks. So following the conclusion of this game, we're going to have an award ceremony. We'll announce our all-MVP or all-tournament team, including the MVP. We'll announce our Coach of the Year and give out some hardware, and I'm pretty sure one of these nets are going to come down. 8 minutes to go now. Hawks have it. Brown lost the handle, out of bounds, knocked away by the Lakers. So they're now trailing by four. They're more as one of two from the line. Sissy checks in. Nice job there to get it. That was inside to Smith, but her shot was short. Sissy able to disrupt that shot. Gray tries to drive on Blevins and lost header pass picked off by Gingras. Gingras shot was off the mark, kind of off the side of the backboard. Had a good opportunity there, but just well defended by the Lakers. So 4 points is still the lead by the Lakers, 47-43. Terea Moore checks back in. Three-pointer on the way for Watson. That's good. Chloe Watson now with 13 points. The lead is seven. Lakers Nation here to my right. They're starting to feel it. I don't think there's an empty seat. From my vantage point, you can't see it on camera, though, unfortunately. Blevins with a shot off the window. The off-balance shot, that goes. Exactly what the Hawks needed right there. Blevins now with 10. Our lead is 50-45 in favor of the Lakers with 7:06 left here in the fourth quarter. That's a full timeout. So we'll take a break. We'll be right back. Thanks, everybody, for tuning in. All right, 7:06 left here in the fourth. Lakers trying to close this one out. They lead by five over the Hawks. Rezio goes down to the block, kicks it back out up top to Gray for three. And Watson with the board. Nice offensive rebound there by Chloe Watson. Gray Moore had position, but Trinity Bellard able to seal that off. Four on the shot clock. High off the window, no. Rebound. Gingras for the Hawks. Gingras up the left side. Hands off to Dupler. Cross pass to Brown. Gingras for three. That's off the side of the rim. Chloe Watson with that board. Off and running the other way. Three-pointer, that's good. Caitlin Walter from downtown. Walter now with, that's 8 points for Walter. And that lead is 8 points. Inside the paint, that's Blevins. Got her own shot, or rebound off her own shot. The putback's no good. But she's fouled. She'll be heading to the line. She'll be shooting two. That foul's on Terea Moore. I believe that's her fourth. It is. So she comes out along with Gray. Kaylee Hooker checks back in. And it looks like Paige Ebels. Hooker checks back in. She's got only 5 points, but she's got 11 boards here this afternoon. Getting it done on the glass. All right, 6 point lead, 53-47, 5:41. That's 12 points now for Blevins. Ebel drives baseline. Ron Blevins dropped it for Hooker. But Blevins steps in with the steal. Blevins got it to go barely. Hooker all over her. Blevins cuts the lead to 4 points. It's Lakers. 53-49, 5:14 left. Hawks looking for a stop. And Brown, they're going to call her on the blocking foul. That is the third foul now on Brown. Third team foul for the Hawks. Looks like Courtney Smith checking back in. Trinity Bellard checking out for the Hawks. Terea Moore with a shot. Nice inbound play for her. And she hit the deck. Courtney Smith gets the foul call, and she heads right to the bench. She knew it. That's her fifth foul. Trinity Bellard checks back in. So down to one player left on the bench for the Hawks. It's like that's Dasani Morrill. Morrill with the make. pushes the lead back to 5 points. Made him bowl. Moore with four. Jeriatu Sisse, or Sissy checks in. Sissy, Walter, Rezio, Watson, and Evil. You got Gingras, Bellard, Brown, Dupler, and Blevins. That's blocked by Sissy. That might be your fourth block today. I'm pretty sure. Let me double check. That's her third block. And Courtney Smith with three blocks for the Hawks. An offensive foul call on number two. That's on Dupler. So that's three now on Dupler. 4:50 left in the fourth District A Championship Great Lakes Tournament. Appreciate you all tuning in. Inside the Ebles. That shot is short off the side of the rim. Blevins with the board. Comes out running the other way. Drops it for Brown. Brown on the wing. Trying to get around Watson. Up and under. Drop pass there for... That was Bellard, but that shot was off the mark. She gets the offensive board, and she's fouled. Sissy gets called for the foul. That's her first foul, second team foul here in the quarter. Lakers are already in the bonus the other way. 4:23 left. 6-point lead. Gingras has it. Lefty in the lane, no. And Bellard with the offensive rebound. And I think that's going to be a foul call on the Lakers. Rezio, her third team foul now for the Lakers. Hooker checks back in. Ebel checks out. 4:18 on the clock. Blevins drives. Outlet to Brown. 4-3 on the wing, and that's off the front of the rim. Nice job by Blevins to try to track that one down in the corner. But it goes out of bounds off the Hawks. It's Lakers basketball up by six. I'm going to say we have too many players on the court for the Lakers. Sissy goes out. The Lakers are trying to get a little mini auto there. And Trinity Bellard came in the middle of it and started clapping. That was pretty funny. I don't know if you picked that up on your screen or not, but they double team Rezio, and it's like a timeout on the floor. So Lakers timeout, I'm assuming. It's a 30-second timeout. Lakers timeout with 4:04 left on the clock here in the fourth quarter. It's the Lakers 55 and the Hawks 49. We'll be right back. I don't know if we have a most spirited fan award here in the Great Lakes Tournament, but I think the award's got to go to the Laker fans. They got coordinated cheers. They're practically doing the waves here in Steve Schmidt Gymnasium. They're trying to will their team to victory. Out of bounds. Off the Hawks, they say. It's Lakers basketball. 3:56 left. They lead by 5, 55-49. We've had some great crowds in this gym this weekend. It's been a lot of fun. I think the next one's going to be a rematch of the Roadrunners and Skippers. They played here about a week ago. I remember calling that game. Walter for three, and that goes out of bounds. No, kept alive by Watson. What a play by Chloe Watson. Rezio for three. And that's going to be a shot clock violation. But good job there by Watson to keep that alive. And Rezio got a shot off. If anything, it carved away another 7 to 10 seconds off the clock for the Lakers. So Hawks got a score. They're down six. Plenty of time left with 3:29. Gingrich drives baseline, spins, and finds Bellard on the cut. She goes to the basket, but she's fouled. I think she's going to be heading to the line shooting two. And that's on Rezio. That's fourth foul on Rezio, the leading scorer for the Lakers. So 3:22 left. Moore checks back in. Bellard averaging about 52%. Paige Ebels checks in as well. I think Rezio checks out. Bellard missed the first. Lakers trying to figure out their position there. Everybody moving around. But all right, here we go. Bellard, the free throw. Made the second. So it's a five-point lead. 3:22 left, 55-50. Watson has it up the middle of the court. Drops it for Ebel. Hawks looking for a stop. And that was knocked loose by Bellard. Shot clock now at 14. Ebel has it. Looking for a cut. That's Gray. Too hot to handle. Picked up by Blevins the other way. She got Moore behind her. Knocked it loose. Great defensive play there by Moore. Caused that turnover. And Brown's going to get called for the foul. That's going to put Chloe Watson on the line as the Hawks are already have their fifth foul. So Watson averaging 78%. Watson made the first. 6-point lead, 2:51. Nice offensive board there by Gray. Kept it alive for the Lakers. They lead by six. Watson drives on Blevins, looking for an outlet. Caitlin Walter with it. Shot is off the mark. Blevins with the board. Dupler's shot rolls off the rim, and that's Bellard, knocked out of bounds. That's Laker basketball. Blevins leading away with 14 for the Hawks. Gingrich with 10. Watson with 14. 3 of 7 from downtown. 8 boards as well. 3 rebounds. Great game for Chloe Watson. She's walking it down the middle of the court right now. Coming up on 2 minutes to play. It's Lakers lead by 6. And Chloe Watson head the line to shoot 2. That's Dupler's 4th foul. Tay and Brown with 4 fouls. Dupler now with 4 fouls. Courtney Smith has already fouled out. Watson pushes the lead to 8, 58-50, 2:10. And Bellard got it to go. Nice job there by Bellard in traffic. She's got 7 points, so 58-52 with 2:04 left here in the fourth quarter. We got a timeout on the floor. That's a Hocking Hawk timeout. We'll be right back. Thank you. All right, inbound play coming for the Lakers. 2:04 left. They lead by 6. Almost stolen there by Brown. Walter couldn't get the handle on it. Blevins, Dofort knocked it out of bounds. So that stops the clock with exactly 2 minutes to go. The Hawks are going to get it done. They got to do it now. They come out with a press double team on. That was on Rezio. Lakers able to get it up in the midcourt, and a travel call. They forced a turnover. Hawks were swarming. Gray gets called for the travel. So 1:52 left. Hawks team still hanging around. They led at halftime by 4. Or make that 5, 26-21. Brown has it. Watson all over her. Brown up across the timeline. Six points is your deficit. Hawks looking for an open shot. No easy shot, says the Lakers, and they lost the ball. The Hawks did. Lakers pick it up. Chloe Watson, right place at the right time. Kicks it out to Rezio. Thought about the three. Thought better of it. Let's kill some clock. She dribbles across midcourt. And finally, foul call. Trinity Bellard got her. That's going to be 4 now on Bellard. No fouls left to give, obviously. The Lakers in the bonus. Kaylee Hooker checks in. Gray goes out. 1:21 left. It's 58-52. Rezio at the line can put this thing away. Averaging 89% from the strike. I would imagine that's got to be pretty high up the charts in the conference. Yeah, she's third overall in conference, first overall. So 60-52. And out of bounds, it's still Hawks basketball, 107 left. Lakers lead by 7. Yeah, I'm confused by that. So she's 88% first overall as a category. Then conference, she's third. I don't know how that's possible, but maybe I've just done too many basketball games over the last couple, 2-3 days here. Brown has it, 12 on the shot clock. Three-pointer, that's off the mark. Rebound Moore. Blevins all over her, outlet to Watson. Cross midcourt, and Brown, I think that's going to be her fifth. Yeah, Watson doing push-ups over there in front of the bench. She got fouled, hit the deck. So Watson's going to head back to the line. Watson now with... Watson with 16. Dasani Morrow checks in. I don't think there's any more fouls. If Dupler fouls out or Bellard, I don't think we're going to have anybody left to come in off the bench. Watson with the make. She's got 17. It's 11-point lead, 53. Made them both. 18. Gingrich. Drops it to Bellard. Inside to Blevins. Loose ball. That's picked up by Dupler. 16 on the shot clock. Bellard to Blevins. Inside to Bellard. Give and go. Nice job there by the Hawks to get a quick basket. They call timeout with 33 seconds left on the clock. It's a 62-54 lead for the Lakers. So immediately following, we're going to give our presentation of the award ceremony, and I know they're going to announce the MVP as well as the all-conference or tournament team, and we'll cut down the net, do all that good stuff for the champion. They're going to be heading out to the national championship. Looks like that is going to be held at the Leggett and Platt Athletic Center out in Joplin, Missouri on the 18th. Jets already punched their ticket today, the Jackson College Jets. They'll be heading out there. I got to get a look at that bracket. I understand there's some at-large invites. I'll get with our athletic director here, Al Perry. That Lansing team was 20. What did they finish? 25-5, I believe. So they came up short today in the championship game. Be interested to see if they get the invite out there. And Lakers hoping to continue their season, but they got about 33 seconds left. They're 13-5 right now overall. They've gotten it done here in Flint Town so far. They were able to put away Kellogg, the Cougars, 85-75 in that first round matchup. Watson has it, double team there, Blevins and Bellard, an offensive foul call on Watson. Blevins hit the deck. That's a first foul on Watson. But that's five fouls now for the Lakers. Hawks will be in the bonus. Just 30 seconds left. Gingrich has it, drives. Gets a shot off high off the backboard. And that is Trinity Bellard there for the offensive board, the putback. And she's fouled. Terea Moore gets called for the foul. That's her fifth. She comes out. Haley Hooker checks back in. Terea Moore finishes with 4.7 boards for the Lakers. Clocked at 21.9. Moore at the line shooting two. Or excuse me, Bellard at the line shooting two. Bellard make the second. 62-55, 21.9 inbound. Lakers, they have it. Long pass up to Kaylee. Hooker up and no good. Blevins able to track that down. Hooker just had too much time. Morrow has it back up top to Dupler. Gingras for three. That's short. Rezio has it. Outlet to Watson, and that should do it. And that's a final. Your District 8 champion, Great Lakes Tournament, is the Mid-Michigan College, the Lakers. They improved to 29-1 overall. They get it done today, 62-55 over the Hawks from Hocking College. Congratulations to the Lakers for getting it done here in District A. Definitely I want to give congratulations and some accolades to the Hawks for getting it done to get this far. They played well. They led at the half, but the Lakers were just too much for them. They came back. They outscored the Hawks to start the third, 25-17. They built a lead going into the fourth, and they outscored the Hawks by 4-16-12. So 62-55 is your final score for the Lakers. Chloe Watson with 18 points, along with 8 boards and 3 assists, a couple of steals on defense. Rezio, 15 points, 5 rebounds. And 3 steals for her. Gray had 8. Caitlin Walter with 8. Hooker with 5. Moore with 4. Sissy with 2. Evils with 2. Evils, excuse me. All right, so we're going to announce our all-tournament team. And I will share those with you, and then we'll let our guy Dante bring it home.
We would like to present the award for the all-tournament team. Today, Scott Farlow, Women's Region 12 Director, and Tom Healy, the Tournament Director in of Hocking Community College, will present the award. First up, for our all-tournament team, Schoolcraft College, we have number 30, Demi Rodriguez.
Demi Rodriguez from Schoolcraft, the Ocelots, made the alternative team.
Number three, Kaylee Glennon.
Kaylee Glennon. Emily Blevins gets all conference or all tournament recognition.
Also from Hocking, number 32, Brielle Gingrich.
Brielle Gingrich from Hocking, all tournament team.
From Mid Michigan. Number 22, Rachel Rezio.
Rachel Rezio. Laker.
And your 2024 Great Lakes District 8 Tournament MVP from Mid Michigan College. Number 14, Chloe.
And no surprise there. Chloe Watson is your MVP of District A. 18 points and 8 rebounds today. And in their earlier matchup.
And now.
See, I can give you some stats there. There's our honors there. So Watson with 31 points in the first game. So no surprise there. Hocking is your runner-up. So they're going to get their awards. The Lakers will get the awards. We'll cut down the net. So I'll let Dante take it home. Thanks, everybody. My name is Chad Toms. I truly appreciate you tuning in today for this District B championship game. Appreciate all the help online with some of the fans there keeping me straight. But the names, I love it. And you guys have a great rest of your day. Tune in for the next game, the Skippers and the Roadrunners. That one's going to be a fun one. So we'll get that one underway. We'll be back here tomorrow. 3 more games in our men's championship. So once again, my name is Chad Toms. Appreciate the opportunity to bring you the game. Have a great night, and I'll let Dante bring it home. See you, everybody.
And 32, Brielle Ingress. Also, Nishela McDonald. Assistant coach, Trevor Blevins. Assistant coach, Mandy Martin. And the individual award and the Great Lakes District A runner-up trophy presented to head coach Seth Martin. Congratulations on a phenomenal season. And now, let's meet the individual team members of the Great Lakes District A women's basketball champion, the Blue Michigan. Number 2, Addison Gray. Number 3, Geriatu Stacy. Number 5, Delaney Seaman. Number 10, Paige Eagle. Number 11, Caitlin Walter. Number 1, Leah Helton. Number 13, Jordan Lawrence. Number 14, Chloe Watson. Number 20, Soraya Moore. Number 21, Andy Rayfield. number 22, Rachel Rezio. Number 34, Callie Hooker. Jenna Butcher. And Gaia Presley. Assistant coach and trainer, Smith. Assistant coach, Austin Mayfield. Assistant coach, Jewel Larkin. And assistant coach, Kristen Boer. And the Great Lakes District A Women's Basketball Coach of the Year, Head Coach Lance. And so maybe here's the Great Lakes District A Women's Basketball, Teddy and Joe Brown, congratulations! And thank you to the Lakers next week in Stockton, Missouri for the National Championship. And now, we'll have our ceremonial net cutting for the Mid-Michigan Lakers, our 50A Women's Basketball Champion.
You can see everybody there on the left side of your screen. Net is going to be cut here shortly. And congratulations once again to the Lakers. They got it done in the second half to get it done. So one shining moment coming up. All right, we'll see you here for our nightcap, the Skippers and the Roadrunners. Once again, thank you for tuning in. Appreciate everybody at home. Thanks to the mock staff here, everybody at the table in the back room getting it done. Congratulations to the Lakers. They are advancing.
Thank you.